Hello, my name is Robert Dean Steele, and I'm here again to give you a promise from the Word of God. Proverbs chapter 19, verse number 11. Listen to this. Solomon writes there and says, "A person's wisdom yields patience. It is to one's glory to overlook an offense." Now, many who are going to be watching this video probably from time to time have a problem with anger. Can I confess something to you? When I was younger, I really did have a problem with anger. There was a lot of in what I would call pent-up emotions that were ready to come out to the surface. And for no apparent reason, I would just explode all over the place. And my greatest shame, I think, in this area was I used to be proud of my anger. I used to say, "Don't get me mad. I'll blow up right in front of you, and you don't want to see it." And I used it as a mechanism to control those around me. Do you know someone who controls people around them with their anger? Don't get them mad, you know. But you know what? The Bible does not, I would say, look at anger as a good thing. Unless, of course, it's righteous anger. Then, of course, when you're angry over the right thing, over the things that God looks at. So how does one get over anger? Well, James has a really wonderful promise in James 1, 19 and 20. He says, first of all, be quick to hear. Absolutely important, quick to hear. Make sure that what you're hearing is correct. Be slow to anger, or slow to speak is the next one. So before you open your mouth, engage your brain. Very, very important. And then he says, be slow to anger. So really, to overcome anger, be quick to hear, be slow to speak, and certainly be slow to anger. And make sure that you're angry at the right reasons, for the right situation. Jesus, for example, we know that he displayed some righteous anger. He literally overturned all the tables of the money changers and drove them out with a whip. But the reason he was angry is they had turned the temple of God into a place of business, and it was never designed to be that way. So if you come across an angry person, here is a little rule of thumb. It says it is to one's glory to overlook an offense. Sometimes things need to be corrected. I'm not saying that from time to time a person needs to be confronted, but if it's one of those situations where you're thinking, I'll let it go, then let it go. Ask the Holy Spirit, though, before you say anything. Holy Spirit, do I need to deal with this? Do I need to say something about it? And give me the right motives and the right outlook before I open my mouth. You know what will happen? You will be able to turn away anger. In fact, the Bible says a soft answer turns away wrath. Remember that. My name is Robert Dean Steele. This is a promise from the Word of God, and you have yourself a great and godly day. Oh, by the way, let me give you a couple more scriptures. Psalm 25, 28, Ecclesiastes 7, 8, and of course, James 1, 19 and 20. God bless.